consciously to develop their skills. I mean, the person may be technically good, but may not necessarily be cut out for, let's say, a business development or a CEO role. You know, and we should recognize that in every business enterprise, there are different roles with different resources. Okay, but all these things go together to make a success story of a certain idea or a concept. Okay, in ICT. So I am of the view that the government as well as the private sector should all move together to help bring some impetus to the hunger and thirst by young, talented Ghanaians who are looking to make something out of themselves for the talents and the skills that they've got in ICT. The conscious investment in ICT education should also carry on. Recently, there is all in the news about distribution of laptops and so on. I hope these are, you know, a very, very tropical item and sustainable and durable and have full warranties inside them. You know, but it's not just enough about laptops. I hope there is also a package for connectivity to internet, because a lot of the resources that these people are going to require are sitting on debt. So all these linkages will definitely have to come in to help move the ICT industry forward. Thanks.
Thank you for the conference, for your contributions, and thank you, delegates, for your feedback as well as your ideas. Yes, it is not the role of multinational necessarily to develop the technology industry in Africa, but they definitely have a role to play. And they have a reasonable or even fairly successful so far in the last 3 or 4 decades, but more than that. Also, I get a point of my Nigerian colleague regarding the role of government. It's a little bit controversial because in the United States, it's the development of the technology industry, which basically started in Silicon Valley. It's basically powered primarily by the private sector. When you go to China, the other way around, the government has a very solid plan. Almost all the tech parks, as recently as 1985, there was no tech park in China, but now there are more than 50 all over the place. Most of them developed by the government. They are working pretty well. So government, I believe, has a role to play. Just a matter of how and what coordination meaning, how significant a role should the government play in the development of
partnered with two angles, one with mentorship and one with what is now becoming a big deal in Europe, innovation labs. Today's innovation might be tomorrow's something else. So if I develop a program today and I don't do any incremental innovation or managing it, tomorrow there might be another thing altogether. So I think we need some innovation labs around that younger people who have the zeal to do some form of innovation can go there. There's some form of mentorship where the multinationals come in also, because yeah, they have the money. So how do you assist the younger ones who want to improve themselves in that sector? Some mentorship would need to be brought in there to guide these young ones who have the zeal to write programs, to ask one of them was talking about, they come with PowerPoints which are not well structured, but if there's nobody to help them structure the PowerPoint, we can never get there. So they need some form of mentorship, they need some form of guidance. We need some centers around where the young ones or startups can go there to meet some collaboration among not only IT people, but students from the business background and students from the IT background coming together. I think when such collaborations also come into force, so many good things can come about. Lastly, I'll say I think Africa or West Africa, we have a generally good market, and a lot of multinationals are coming in because of the goodwill that is here. There's a high level of entrepreneurship, and if we are able to exploit these very well and commercialize the innovations that will come out of it, we'll get somewhere and we'll be proud of it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, that brings us to the end of day one. I did say earlier on that the four gentlemen we had to discuss this topic were very knowledgeable. They have, haven't they been?
They have.
Let's thank them once again. Thank you very much for your very insightful contributions. We appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you very much to everybody else for coming. I hope this session has been very good for you. I was expecting an enriching experience, and I think I've certainly had it. A lot of ideas that have been exchanged, some ideas that I have picked for myself, from the keynote speeches through to the panel discussions and workshops, quite a lot have been shared. I hope everybody has got something to take away to either impact your organization that you're coming from, or something that can help your personal endeavor in times down the road. So it's been a good experience from my perspective, and I hope it's been like that from yours. Tomorrow, we'll be here at 8:30 for a 8:45 start. Let everybody get off the road so you don't get stuck in traffic, so you can get there on time. Anybody gets on the road, just hit the back of them and get on the road. So that's tomorrow. 8:30 assembly for 8:45 starts. For this evening though, between now and 12:00, 7:30, we've got the cocktail dinner taking place at the pool bar. A time for a lot more networking, a lot more interactions, to build up a portfolio of partners, people that